Jesus then had finished with all these sayings, he said to his disciples,
"Ye know that after 2 days is the Passover, and the Son of Man shall be to his foes delivered. And on the cross he shall perish."
Counsel there, how that Jesus by craft be taken and put to death. But thus they shouted, "Now when Jesus sauntered in Bethany, abiding with Simon the leper, came to him a maid who carried a flask with exquisite ointment and poured it on his head as he reclined at meat. But when his disciples saw it, they spoke angrily to the woman,
kingdom shall be spoken in her remembrance.
One of Jesus' 12 disciples, whose name was Judas Iscariot, went to Caiaphas' palace and spoke,
"What sum will ye give me? I will to you betray him."
And they offered him 30 silver pieces. From that moment sought he opportunity that he might betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread there came all the disciples to Jesus and said unto him, as had been told them to do by Jesus, and prepared the Lamb of Passover. And that night he was at table with all his 12 disciples, and as they ate, he told them,
"Truly I say to you, one of you here with me shall betray me."
And they grew exceeding sad, and they began to question him every one, and to say unto him,
betray me, the Son of has to go the road, as the scriptures have foretold him. But woe unto that man by whose word the Son of Man betrayed shall be. It would have been better, yea, far better for him, had he not been created.
The retort came from Judas, who did betray him. He spoke,
not I, Master.
He said to him,
thou sayest.
And as they were eating, he took of the loaf, blessed and broke the bread, gave it to them while he spoke.
This is my body, take it and eat.
And he took a cup, gave thanks to God, and gave it to them and said,
drink ye all of this wine. It is my blood, the testament of man, which shall be shed for you.
and they sung a hymn of praise together. On the mount of olives they gathered. Thus was spoken by Jesus.
This very night, all of ye will be much angered with me. In the scriptures is written, I shall have the shepherd stricken, and the sheep in the pasture, like the leaves, shall be scattered. But when I am resurrected, I shall precede you into the land of Galilee.
Here we pause for a brief intermission in this performance of the St. Matthew Passion by Bach. Erich Leinsdorf conducting the Rochester Philharmonic Orchestra with Rudolf Petrak narrator, James Pease, Jesus, with Ann Ayars soprano, Margaret Harshaw alto, and Norman Farrow bass, and the combined choirs of Rutgers University, the New Jersey College for Women, and a girls' choir from the Rochester Public Schools. Now, one moment, please. Now, the final portion of the St. Matthew Passion, Part 1, by Bach, under the leadership of Erich Leinsdorf.
Peter then gave him answer, and thus he said,
what if they all are angry because of thee? For my part, I shall never be angry.
Jesus said to him,
truly I say to thee, this very night, before the cock croweth, wilt thou have three times denied.
Peter said to him,
and if I had to perish with thee, yet I shall never deny thee.
And likewise also said all the others. At that time Jesus came to a garden with them, the place Gethsemane, and he told his disciples,
"Sit ye now here until I go up yonder and pray there."
And took with him Peter and also both the sons of Zebedee, and began with prayer and with mourning. Thus was spoken by Jesus,
"In my soul there is much grief, even unto death. Tarry here and watch ye with me.
For his father,
for salvation. The love of God toward man commended. He's prepared to drink the cup of death. It's bitter chalice with all the sins of mortals spilled and brimming o'er with hate and malice. But it must be as God has
He came again and found them sleeping, for all their eyes were heavy with sleep. And he left them and went back for the third time, praying as he did before, and spoke again the same words in prayer. Returning to his disciples, he spoke with sadness.
Ah, are ye still sleeping and resting? Truly, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is delivered up into the hands of the sinners. So arise, let us be going. Look ye, he is here who does betray.
And while he was speaking thus, truly, there came Judas, the one disciple, and with him came a large array, with lances and with cudgels, from the chief high priest and the elders of the people. Now this same Judas who betrayed him had given to them a sign, and said, "Whom I shall kiss before you is he. You seize him." And soon he stepped up to Jesus and said,
"All hail to thee, O Master,"
and gave him a kiss. Jesus gently spoke to him,
"My friend, to what purpose come you?"
Then instantly they came, and putting their hands right on Jesus, they seized and took him.
Thank you.
one of the few men that had been with Jesus, drew his sword as lightning and hit the high preserving man and cut the man's ear off. Then said Jesus to him,
"Put back thy sword into its place, for he whose sword kills by violence too shall perish. For believe you not that I could not make prayers to my Father, that he sent to me here more than 12 legions of angels? But how shall then be fulfilled the scriptures? It must go as they say."
In that hour spoke Jesus to the people,
"Have ye sallied out to seize me as a robber, with lances and with cudgels to arrest me? Day after day have I sat among ye. I taught every day in the temple, yet he never thought to take me. All of this was done and accomplished to fulfill the scriptures.
Then abandoned he all his friends and disciples.
Mm-hmm.
those who had taken Jesus led him away to the palace of the chief high priest, where all the scripture scholars and elders together were assembled. Peter, who had followed after him afar off, into the court of the high priest's palace, and entered in, and sitting beside the servant, that he might witness how it would be ending. The chief priest then and all of the elders too, and the Sanhedrin were intent on finding some false witness, that Jesus be put to death. And they found nothing. bitter mean first at altar in the hall. And there came a maid servant to him and said,
"You are so overseen with this given."
But he in the sight of them all denied it and said,
"I don't know what you speak of."
And again at the palace gateway, he was seen by another maid, who said to all those who were present,
"This is one of them with Jesus the Nazarene."
He denied it a second time, and swore an oath,
"I never have known that man."
And in a little while there came an armed of bystanders to him, and spoke thus to Peter,
"Rabbi, tell us who are to give us this chance to the
and we swearing,
"I know not the man at all."
And soon the cock began to crow. Then Peter brought to mind the words of Jesus, as he had foretold him, "Before the cock crows at dawn, wilt thou have three times denied me?" Then he went out while we. castle heard by priests and elders of the people to plot against Jesus, that he be put to death. When he was bound, they led him away and handed him over to Pontius Pilate, the governor in power. When Judas perceived him, he who had thus betrayed him, that Jesus had been convicted, he felt remorse and fell, and went to the priest to return the 30 pieces of silver which he had taken, and he said,
I know the evil I did, betraying innocent blood to you for silver.
They shouted, pieces in the temple, and he went off away, and he hanged himself and died. Meanwhile, the high priest gathered quickly the silver pieces and spoke thus. Just at the time that he had a prisoner, a notorious one whom the people knew, named Barabbas. And when they were all assembled, he was asking the people,
which one shall I now release at your bidding, Barabbas or this of whom it has been said he be Christ?
He was well aware that they had delivered him up out of envy. And when he took the judgment seat, came there from his wife to him a message saying,
do let alone this innocent man you are holding.
All the priests and elders persuaded them, slyly talking to the crowd, to ask that Barabbas be released and that Jesus should perish. To the multitude did then the governor speak and ask them,
have you chosen which of these two men here shall be to you released now?
They shouted,
Barabbas!
The governor continued,
but what shall I do with this Jesus, of whom is said that he be Christ?
Again they shouted,
have him to hold.
Thank you. As we pause for a brief intermission in this performance of the St. Matthew Passion by Bach, Jesus, accused, stands before Pontius Pilate. Erich Leinsdorf is conducting the Rochester Philharmonic Orchestra in this performance presented by NBC's regular Saturday concert series, Pioneers of Music. James Pease sings the role of Jesus, Rudolf Petrak, the narrator, with Ann Ayars, soprano, Margaret Harshaw, alto, and Norman Farrow, bass, with choirs from Rutgers University, the site of this afternoon's performance, and the New Jersey College for Women. Our concert will continue after a brief pause for station identification. The Passion According to St. Matthew by Johann Sebastian Bach. In the concluding portions now, we hear the final acts in the life of Jesus, the release of Barabbas, and the demand of the crowd that Jesus be crucified, the scourging and crowning with thorns as Jesus is crowned and mocked as King of the Jews, the way of the cross, the crucifixion, the death of Christ, after the crucifixion, the descent from the cross, and the burial.
They shouted fiercer than ever to him. Washed his hands before the crowd and said,
"If this innocent man shall die, I am not guilty. It is your care."
Then did all the people answer him and said,
Thank you.
the evening hour, a strange, mysterious darkness fell on the entire land, and lasted to the ninth hour. At night, when Jesus could not bear the pain, he cried and said, "Eli, Eli, lama, lama sabachthani." That is, who stood and watched him heard Jesus calling thus, they all said,
"He called us for Elijah."
After one of them went running and took a sponge in vinegar, soaked it fully, and fastened it upon a reed to give him to drink. The other said with mocking, "And again did Jesus cry out aloud, and he died."
Rose.
graves after Jesus' resurrection and came into Jerusalem then and appeared to Mary. Now when the captain and the others with him who were there watching Jesus saw the earthquake and all that had happened at the time, they trembled with fear for saying, burial place, an enormous boulder. He Secure, they sealed it and put guards.